Hey guys, welcome back. This is the lecture number 63 of our bootcamp series. In this lecture, we will discuss about active record queries in brief but in good enough details to start working with ORM queries. So let's start with active record queries definition. What is active record query? So active record queries are the best way to perform database operation in Rails rather than writing raw SQL queries. With active record queries, you can perform your database operations or queries in a very simpler way. Okay, for example, if you have to fetch all the students from database, then with active record query, you just need to write student.all and this will give all the existing students in the database. But with raw SQL query, you have to run select star from students, okay, which is a raw SQL query. So this is very simple operation. Now let's consider one more example that suppose if you have to fetch a single student from database with an ID provided, okay, then with SQL active record query, you should write only student.find and then provide the ID as argument, okay, and it will find or it will fetch the specific student from the database with the ID provided. But with raw SQL, you have to write something like select star from students where students.id equal to ID. Okay. So these are just two examples showing the advantage of writing active record queries over raw SQL queries. Okay. And you can simply see that writing active record queries is much simpler and convenient over raw SQL queries. Okay. Now, let's discuss few of the methods available to perform active record queries to make database operation simpler. So in this lecture, I'm only just listing the methods that we will discuss in this course. Okay. But I will not discuss these query in details here, but I'm just showing the name of the methods, SQL active record query methods that we're going to discuss, that find, find by, first or last, where, order, select, and limit. These are very few basic but most frequently used active record queries that you will find in almost all the Rails application. Okay, and we will discuss each of these methods in details in coming lectures. I will prepare a separate lecture on each of these query methods. So that's all from this lecture. Let's meet into the next lecture with the uses and explanation of find query method. Okay, so thanks for watching this. Till then, tata, goodbye, take care and stay safe.